This is Jack Lasculli in Cincinnati, Ohio, at Crosley Field. Somewhere above, but certainly not apart from Midsummer Rock. In the next 90 minutes, we'll be attempting to communicate an act of the new generation, a happening, an event, an occurrence, if you will, that to some seems most ordinary, while to others borders on the occult. A rock festival is not something you program, but rather something with which you try to keep up. We foresee a day of chasing images, pursuing sounds, and trying to keep pace with the action. Join us then as we go down on the field for the first group, Grand Funk Railroad.
What their problems are, what people think.
Lonely like a broken man. I serve my time doing the best I can. Balls and bars, they surround me. But I don't want no sympathy. On my mind and hands, I work all day making up nickel bags and.
No!
right now, mama. I need you right now, baby. Right by my side, honey. Get down with me. I'll make you feel real good. I just watch and see. Thank you.
Some of those dudes over here have two stones. Somebody take them up and move.
There seems to be something happening down there. That's Mike Quattro, the promoter of the concert, and he seems to be uptight about something. One of our reporters, Gary Schaefer, is on hand. Let's listen in.
Backstage once again, and there's still a delay before... Oh, and the people are rushing the stage one more time, coming all the way up in the front. And Mike, that affects you. This is Mike Quattro, one of the promoters of the show. Mike, problems, right?
Well, we originally had a grass area set up. Unfortunately, the rain kind of ruined the grass area, and then, secondly, which made it even worse, we had to move the stage back to second base because of the size of the crowd, which eliminated the grass area that they had originally given us, and they wouldn't give it back to us.
I see. In other words, what do you estimate your crowd at right now?
I couldn't say. I'd say it's 25,000 people or whatever. They're not rushing the stage. They're in the dirt part of the infield. We announced that they can come into the dirt part of the infield. You see, the weird thing about the whole thing was that we had permission to have grass from home base back. We had offered to pay for the sod of the entire thing in case it got ruined. At that point, we decided that if the stage was at home base, the viewing would not be exemplary because of the size of the crowd. We moved the stage back to second base, and they took away from us from home base back. They took away that grass area and gave us the skin part of the infield, which is really not where it's at, but that was their decision.
And I see. Who are they?
The ballpark.
Now we're ready to continue with the concert. Mountain is tuning up on stage, and they feature Felix Pappalardi on bass and Leslie West as lead guitarist.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's go there.
Jim Finger is a man who made it possible that some of the money that this Midsummer Pop Festival realizes gets poured back into the community where it's being held. How did you arrive at this approach to this?
Well, a lot of it came out of the strike at the University of Cincinnati. Throughout the activities there, our consciousness was raised a lot about exploitation, illegitimate authority. And so when this concert came up, we saw this as another example of exploitation. People making a hell of a lot of money off of young people and, you know, not turning the money back to the young people.
You mean the sponsors of the festival?
Right. And record companies, exploitation is using people to make excessive profits. You know, poor workers or whatever. And so we also saw this as a chance to form the beginnings of some understandings between students, blacks, and poor whites, to realize that the struggle that we're all involved in is the same struggle against illegitimate authority and exploitation, and to realize that we do have some rights.
Jim, we'll let you get back to the festival thing.
More coming up on Midsummer Rock after these words.
About 9 hours ago, when I first got here, this street was packed with people waiting to get in. The rain was falling very hard, and people had been here all night waiting for tickets at 6:50 a throw to get in. And then it stopped raining, and the hassling started, and eventually the festival got underway, and it's now evening, and this gentleman has sat through it all very patiently so his children could come, right?
Right.
You brought them down from Battle Creek.
I brought them down from Battle Creek and got here about 11 o'clock last night.
Well, what happened last night? Now, what was it like? There were a lot of people.
Well, it was just a good crowd and a lot of music going on, and everybody was having a good time and no troubles whatsoever, as I seen. And everybody seemed to be just having a lot of fun.
Have you seen your kids today?
Not since they went inside.
What time was that?
Well, they went inside about 10 o'clock.
So that's about 11 hours.
That's about 11 hours. I don't look for them until 12 o'clock tonight.
Yeah, well, what have you been doing, sitting in the car?
Oh, just sitting in the car, and we went for a walk and had a bite to eat and went around and talked to a few people.
Yeah? What'd you talk about?
Well, just everything in general about the crowd and so on.
What do you think of these kids? I mean, the kids going all over the nation now. They've never done that before. These youngsters out on their own and everything. They come to this with their own rules and everything. What do you think of it all?
Well, I think they're a good bunch of kids. I mean, when thousands of kids can get together and there's no trouble. And I see no fights of any kind, no words, and no dirty talking. That's one thing that I was surprised about.
Yeah. Did you ever do anything like this when you
were
a kid?
No.
No? What'd you do?
Nothing. Just work.
All right, well, thanks. That's now we're going to check back with Jack Lascouli in the booth.
Okay, thanks.
We'll be back to listen to more of the music in just a moment after this message. Darkness has settled now on the Cincinnati Stadium, and we're still here. To those of you that will be seeing this program, you will be seeing it in a 90-minute format. We have been here 12 hours as of this minute. Right now, I want to talk to my friend Bob Waller. And Bob, you usually see in sports. This is a new assignment for you, isn't it, Bob?
Well, I guess it's kind of like the decathlon, an endurance event, I think, at this point, Jack.
Now, tell me some of the things that you've been covering down there and the people you've been meeting.
Well, I've been meeting just so many different people, and I mean different types of people and everything. It's just been quite an experience. But I found that the sense of community kind of varies in different places geographically. Like down by the stage, real close, everyone is really into the music. They're really rocking is very hard, getting down on the sound and paying strict attention to the music and dancing and just doing whatever it is they want to do. But you go into the stands, and you know they might be doing reading a book or throwing a frisbee or drinking a lemonade, you know. And the music is kind of like you'd go in your backyard and turn your stereo up and then go prune or something, you know.
You know, one of the things that amazes me is that they do not go about this in a show business way. For instance, when somebody says here's an act and they announce the act, they may very well tune up for 10 or 15 minutes before they ever play the first number that they're going to play. And the kids don't seem to mind this at all. They watch it all and listen to the tune-up and listen to them check speakers. And I think we've got some action coming up now. We'll leave Bob Waller for the moment and go to the stage and listen to Iggy and the Stooges.
Blood. She got a TV. I She got a TV. She got a TV on me. She had a TV on me, yo. Yeah.
Down in the field with the crowd. I don't know just where, but we'll find him.
You're on. Okay. We mentioned earlier that different parts of this festival geographically have kind of different moods, and this has been one of the nicest places all day because it's one of the few places where there's space and people can just kind of get around and move around and do their whatever there is they're going to do and kind of rest and relax. What's in the bag, man? Hey, what's in there? What is it,
Ben?
Huh?
Find out.
Hold that for me. That would kill me. That's water. That's terrible. That's bad water, too. Where'd you get it? Yeah? You get it out in the desert? That's imported water. I just got to walk over here with Seep. Some of the people are where they're from. Where are you from, man?
Pittsburgh.
Yeah. Did you try again?
No, I got a ride with somebody I know.
Yeah?
Right.
You've been here the whole time?
What?
Been here the whole time?
Yeah, more or less, I guess.
Yeah? Is it all right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Keep it up. From this point, where we're talking to you now, you can only see a portion of the stage, and a lot of times, people can't see anything at all because they're seated. You come out here, you get as close to the stage as you can, and you sit down, you don't see anything.
Right.
What's that?
I don't know.
Huh?
Just come here and have a good time.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Have you been successful so far?
Oh, yeah, real successful.
Yeah? It's been kind of nice, hasn't it?
Yeah, real nice.
Now, this is a lot better, I think, getting in close where they can dance.
Hey, man.
Bob Waller has really been doing a job for us.
Oh, not much.
Yeah,
it was pretty neat when the dude jumped off the scaffold.
He's been working very, very hard. We'll rejoin him shortly as he talks to his friends on the field. But right now, there's a young man who calls himself Al Cooper on stage.
Bodies need rest. We all need rest. Sleep, easy sleep. Thank you.
Bob Waller is still down on the field talking to some of his friends.
What? Oh, well, hello.
Tell them what you groove, man.
Well, like if my mother sees me, she'll really get upset.
She doesn't know you're here?
What?
Does she know you're here?
Oh, yeah.
But why would she be upset if she sees you?
She just can't. She doesn't dig music, right?
Well, she thinks you're up in a seat somewhere.
No. She's just not into music like I am.
She's what?
She's just not into music like I am.
And you think she's upset that you're into it?
Oh, she won't be upset, I don't think. She might be. But, like, if she knows I'm here because of music, like, that'll ease it. You know? That's the real reason I'm
here. We're sorry to interrupt, Bob.
Can you really get into the music here?
Oh, the music's far out.
Right now, though, on stage, Traffic, featuring Stevie Winwood.
There were three men came out of the west. Their fortunes for to try. And these three men made a solemn vow. John Barleycorn must die. They've plowed, they've sown, they've harrowed him in. Through clods upon his head. And these three men made a solemn vow. John Barleycorn was dead. They've let him lie for a very long time, till the rains from heaven did fall, and little Sir John sprung up his head, and so amazed them all. They've let him stand till Midsummer's Day, till he looked both pale and worn. And little Sir John's grown a long, long beard, and so become a man. Size so sharp to cut him off at the knee. They roll him and tie him by the way, serving him most barbarously. They've hired men with the sharp pitchforks who pricked him to the heart. And the Lord, he has served him worse than that, for he's ground him to the cord. Yeah. They've wheeled him around and around a field, till they came onto a barn. And there they made a solemn oath on Harlequin. They've hired man with the Crabtree steps to coach him skin from ball. And the miller, he has served him worse than that, for he's ground him between two stones. Sir John and the Nut Brown Ball, and his brandy in the glass. And little Sir John and the Nut Brown Ball proved the strongest man at last. The huntsman, he can't hunt the fox nor so loudly to blow his horn. And the tinker, he can't mend kettle nor pots without a little barley corn.
Thank you. Thanks. We're going to do a new song off our album, and we haven't got much time, so we're going to get him all in, because Stranger to Himself. Oh,
So that's the Midsummer Pop Music Concert. In its entirety, you'll see it in a much shorter version. We've been sitting here for some 15 hours listening to electronic music. That's almost a little bit more than you want to take at one time. But that's only my reaction, because certainly the youngsters in the crowd here appreciated every single note and everything that went on that stage. I've learned a lot in that they come to have a good time. No trouble, lots of exuberance, lots of horseplay, lots of love. Good night, everybody.